Welcome to the Poplar Bluff Museum. Come with me on a tour. The first part of the museum is the main hallway area that has several galleries of photographs, the Butler County courthouses. And over here are some more photo galleries and our display about the May 9th, 1927 tornado, which is a big historical turning point for Poplar Bluff. There are four rooms downstairs, the Abington Hayworth School Room, the Poplar Bluff Sports Hall of Fame, Connell Hall, which is our veterans room, and Butler County Historical Society, which is general history. There's also eight displays upstairs. Why don't we go in some of the rooms now? This is the Poplar Bluff Sports Hall of Fame. Here are all of the inductees to the Hall of Fame since 1981. The Sports Hall of Fame inducts new members every couple of years or so. So we've recently acquired some new things on Derlin Moore, who is a Poplar Bluff Sports Hall of Fame inductee who has recently passed away. It was very unfortunate that the world lost Derlin Moore, but here is a case that talks about his stellar career as a football player with the New Orleans Saints and also the New York Jets. Of course, he was here first in Poplar Bluff. Here are the display cases for Gene Bess, Tom Hoover, and Sam Gambaluka, all well-known Poplar Bluff sports figures. Another not-so-well-known Poplar Bluff sports figure is Janice Lee Romery. She was recently inducted into the Sports Hall of Fame. She was a five-time Olympian fencer. Across the hall is the Abington Hayworth School Room. The school room tells us all about Poplar Bluff and Butler County school history. We have the largest collection of Poplar Bluff yearbooks that is available. This is the rural Butler County Schools display that highlights where all of the rural schools were located. Some of our other things feature scrapbooks and PTA memorabilia and elementary school memorabilia, and then the replica of the old school room. Let's go see some other rooms in the Poplar Bluff Museum. This is a very special area of the Poplar Bluff Museum and Connell Hall, which is our Veterans Museum. This is the Hall of Heroes, which features veterans who have served in the armed forces. We are still looking for photos of people from Butler County who have served. Please contact us with your photo of your family member. Connell Hall features displays on the Civil War, World War I, World War II, Vietnam, Korea, Cold War, Desert Storm, and the Global War on Terror. Our most meaningful display in this room is about Medal of Honor winner Billy Jean Connell, who gave his life in the service of our country on September 7, 1951 in Korea. At the Poplar Bluff Museum, we feel it's important to always honor our veterans. Now let's go across the hall to the Butler County Historical Society room. This room features history from Butler County and Poplar Bluff, just general history about what it was like to live back in the day, but also from some of our businesses, including the iconic bar from Saracini's store that a lot of people remember being down on Main Street. Some of the other displays feature the Willis Brick Factory, and we're working on a display about the Call of the Wild Museum. And our newest piece is the iconic sign from 303 Liquor Store. Those are some of the things that we have on the first floor. Let's go to the second floor. The best view of the new water tower painting is from the second floor. This was completed last year by our board member, Mike Shane. The main hallway here is our first responders area, including sheriff, police, fire, and highway patrol. In this area, we have the U.S. Forest Service Missouri Conservation Commission room, which features taxidermied animals from the area. Over here, the Bowling Hall of Fame, Telephone Pioneers, medical and golf rooms. This is the postal room, which features history about our postal system in Butler County. This is the Dale Gabler Poplar Bluff People Room. We're still working on this room, so there are some displays we still need to work on. But we've recently acquired this painting of James L. Dalton. He was the person who started the Dalton adding machine company that was in Poplar Bluff around the turn of the last century. Another interesting feature in this room that a lot more people will remember is the Snyder's IGA wall that has the clocks from all over the country. That's kind of our little nod to Louis Snyder. And last but certainly not least is the Scout Room, which features information about Boys and Girl Scouts. We've shown you just a little bit of the Poplar Bluff Museum. There is a lot more to see. Come see us Sundays from 2 to 4 and look around for yourself to see a lot more interesting things. Also, the Poplar Bluff Museum Board does all of this work to keep this museum going. So next time you see a Poplar Bluff Museum Board member, be sure and thank them. And thank you for joining us today.